Hello guys, in previous video we created our image to matrix class. In this video we are going to create our main class, PC class, or our algorithm class, and it is most important file of our project. So let's start. New Python file, algo class. I'm naming it as algo class, or let's say algo class. Okay, and I'm going to import numpy and cv2, and I'm going to import another library, scipy.linglang as slinglang. We are going to use this library for find SVD of matrix. Okay, so now I'm going to create our class. My algo, I'm naming it my algo. First is it's a constructor, and we are going to take many parameters for this class, like image matrix, labels or image labels. Okay, image targets, number of elements, and this image matrix is for training. I'm just typing image matrix, and number of elements also for training. Images width, images height, and quality percentage. This parameter will tell how much dimension we want to reduce and how much quality we want to remain. So now I'm going to just assign these variables just by copy pasting. I'm just pasting this code 2-3-4 times, so it will be more easy to me assign variables. Image targets, number of elements, images width, images height, and quality percentage. Sorry, I'm just going to remove other lines. So we have taken our arguments or parameters. Now I am going to just follow first step, subtract mean phase. So first I am going to find its mean phase. Mean equals to np dot mean self dots image matrix and 1. And one is we are giving parameters to tell in which direction we want to mean. Like if we give argument 0, then it will find mean in this dimension. But these are our dimensions, so we want to find mean for all images. So we are going parameter 1, so mean will find with like this. Okay. Now we are going to convert this mean, transpose this mean, because it is a row vector view, but we want column vector. Convert this mean into a matrix and transpose it. Then we are going to subtract this from our images matrix. Now we are going to create function for reduced dimension, and we are going to use SVD for this. U eigenvalues and v transpose. If you don't know much about SVD, you should watch previous videos. I will provide link in description. Slinglang dot SVD, our image matrix, and we are going to one another parameter pass full matrix equals to true. So what does this parameter tells? So when we are going to find eigenvectors, many of eigenvectors will be in related to eigenvalue 0. So it wants, do you want to get removed your those vectors? But I am saying full matrix means n square cross n square, we will remove them on our own. So now it is full matrix equals to true. Next, now we are going to find value of this p, which we are going to use to use only first starting p vectors. For that I am going to create one another function def q p value, and we are going to give this function eigenvalues, and it will give us value of p. So sum original, total sum of eigenvalues equals to sum of all the eigenvalues, eigenvalues. Let's make it as np dot sum, and let's shift our p function above reduced dimension so it will be more linked. So this was our constructor, this is our p value function. So sum threshold will be sum original multiplied by quality percentage divided by 100. Okay, and we are going to do sum, so let's make a sum temporary equals to 0 and value of p equals to 0, and let's create a loop while sum temp less than sum threshold, keep doing this, sum temp plus equals to eigenvalues pth eigenvalue, and increase value of p and return value of p after completing our loop. So this is our p function. Now we can change our new basic p equals to self dot give value of p, and we are going to pass eigenvalues. So self dot new basis, because we got new basis system, and that will be we only going to choose first p vectors from our u matrix. Okay, and new coordinates will be np dot dot product between transpose of new basis and our image matrix, and we are going to return this new coordinates to our main class. So return these coordinates. So we created constructor, then we reduced dimensions. Now we can easily find new coordinates of any point, like this is function for new coordinates. We just going to pass any image matrix, single image matrix to this function, and it will return new coordinates. So first we have to convert this matrix into a vector, that will be np dot as matrix single image matrix, sorry this is single image. So we are going to first convert this into a matrix and then convert this into vector using Revel, and this is a row vector, so we are going to convert this into column vector just by taking transpose. But now we have our old mean, we are going to find new mean, because we are adding new vector, so there will be new mean. So new mean will be old mean into old points, old images, number of old images means length of labels that were number of images. Okay, and close this in one more bracket, plus our image vector, and divide this whole thing by total number of images, total number of labeled images, and our plus our for our one vector. So our images vector will be images vector minus new mean. So this is our new image vector, and we can now easily find new coordinates. Return self dot np dot our basis, its transpose, and multiply it with our vector. So what we done, we for new coordinates we get image, then convert it into a matrix, into a vector, take it transpose of this vector, and find new mean using old mean, and then we subtracted this new mean from image vector, and we then find new coordinate. So our all functions are complete except recognize function, recognize face. So we are going to pass parameters, means new coordinates of an image, and we are going to recognize that image. So for that we are going to find means of each class. So total number of classes are length of our means how many types of elements, number of elements. Now I'm going to create an variable equals to start equals to 0 and distance vector to store distances. So for I in range of classes, so means run loop for whole classes and find mean of all separate classes. So temporary image matrix means for a single type of class will be our new coordinates, and from whole column, but only rows are from starting to number of elements of that class. So this is a temporary matrix only for corresponding to that class. So we can find a mean easily. So mean temporary means only of that class equals to np dot mean of temporary image and in one axis, means from in row direction. And we are going to change number of starting position for next loop, number of elements of this class. Okay, so this is our start. So for find distance I'm going to use distance temporary means only from this class equals to np dot norm, sorry, np dot ling lang dot norm new coordinate, our means new coordinate of image and mean temporary, and we are going to store this distance in our distance array. So how are we going to recognize whose page is this? We are going to find index of that class from which distance is minimum. So minimum position is equals to np dot argument means index of argument of distance vector means which is minimum, and that is name of our person. So target names and that index minimum position. Now we only need to add one more method, but before that remove these three silly mistakes. Be careful. First one is this, we can't use like here, but we have to subtract mean from image vector. And second is in for find distance in norm function we don't use comma, we use subtract sign. And third one is here we used for mean face np as matrix then took transpose, therefore we also have to do the same here, np as matrix dot transpose. So these three are silly mistakes. First one is image vector equals to image vector minus new mean. Be careful about this. Second is in this norm function we have to use subtract sign instead of comma, and here we have to first convert this into a matrix, then take transpose of this mean. Okay. Now last function, def image from path. This function is used for find image from its path, and it need only one parameter, its path. So we already seen how I can read image using CV2. So we are going to read gray image. So provide path and 0 for gray, and then return this image, but resize this image before returning gray image. And these are its parameter, self dot image width and self dot image height. So this is our last method. So let's see once again. First we created our constructor and provided arguments like image matrix, label, etc. Then we reduced its dimension using SVD and find u vector. Then we used p function to find how many vectors we need. Then those will be our new bases, and we finded new coordinates using dot product. Then we finded new coordinates of single image, first converted that image into a vector, then finded new mean and subtracted new mean, and using dot product finded new coordinate. And for recognizing, we finded distance from each class. First we finded means created a temporary matrix of those images, and then created finded a temporary mean of that those matrix, and then we finded a distance and added to distance vector. And after that we finded argument of minimum distance, means which class is at minimum distance, and this will be our phase. And we added one more method for if we provide only path, we then can convert into a gray image, and then we can rescale. And these are only a mandatory method for our class to work, but we are also going to add 2-3 methods or more, like for show icon face, show image, or find original coordinates, but they are not mandatory. So I'm going to create a separate video for those methods and call that optional methods for PCA. So that's all for this video. Thank you for watching. Like my video, subscribe channel. Thank you.